Hey mama, are you struggling with your milk supply? Because if you are, then you better stick around, because in this video, I'm gonna share my top 8 tips for increasing your milk supply fast as a breastfeeding mama. If you don't already know me, my name's Jess, and I created The Innovative Mama to help moms of little ones by sharing tips and tricks about pregnancy and parenting, as well as fun and educational activities for little ones. So if those are things that you're interested in, then make sure to hit that subscribe button and click the notification bell so that you're always notified when I upload new videos. Now let's get into my top 8 tips for increasing your milk supply. One of my biggest tips is to feed a lot, especially within the first couple of days when your baby is born. Now, I understand that some of you may be watching this after the first few days of having your baby, but I always feel the need to let people know about this tip. I was actually keeping my baby on the breast for like well over an hour just because he was kind of using me as a pacifier in the beginning. And I really think that this helped me to have a really solid supply in the beginning. Your body basically produces milk based on the demand of your baby. So in those first few days, especially, the more you have baby on the breast, the more milk you should produce. Now I wanna go ahead and say that although I had an oversupply when I first started, my supply tanked after a few months when I started a diet that was too low in calories. After that, I had to work really, really hard to build my supply back up. Which brings me to our next tip, keep your calories up. Ladies, trust me, I know how it feels to want to shed those pregnancy pounds. I gained 50 pounds during my first pregnancy, and while a lot of that was a lot of extra fluid retention, I definitely wanted to shed the pounds that weren't due to swelling as quickly and as healthily as possible. But unfortunately, I started dieting and my calorie intake was way too low, which in turn caused my supply to drop dramatically. So I no longer had that oversupply that I once did a few months prior. Your body needs extra calories to produce milk, so make sure you don't just make the mistake of dropping calories too suddenly like I did. I would definitely recommend decreasing your caloric intake slowly and not going any lower than 1800 calories a day in order to avoid a drop in your supply. Everyone's body is different and is going to need different requirements, so your calorie requirement to keep your supply up may be different from someone else's. So definitely make sure to go slow and always consult your doctor before starting a diet or exercise program, especially when you're breastfeeding. Going off of tip number 2, tip number 3 is to eat healthy and eat lots of milk boosting foods. Obviously, your baby's nutrition is dependent on yours when you're breastfeeding, so you want to make sure that you're eating a lot of nutrient-rich foods. There are some foods that are also said to boost milk supply, such as oatmeal, almonds, flaxseed, and brewer's yeast, just to name a few. I used to love throwing some brewer's yeast and flax seeds in some healthy smoothies with some protein powder, fruits, and veggies, which was one of the things I did that did help boost my supply after it dropped. So you've probably heard tip number 4 before, which is to drink lots of water. Breast milk is made up of 88% water, so it's super important to stay hydrated when breastfeeding. I noticed that when I would pump that sometimes I would chug some water and my milk started to come down a lot faster. So make sure you always have water on you. I actually used to keep some extra bottles of water at my little breastfeeding spot. So if I forgot my normal water jug, I had them with me. I actually got a huge 64-ounce water bottle from Amazon that I would carry with me in order to measure how much I drank each day. I'll link this in the description box if you want to check it out, but I recommend getting a larger water bottle that can hold a lot of water and then pouring it out into a smaller cup. This way it's easier to make sure you're hitting your water goal for the day. I usually drank 1 to 1.5 of these large water bottles a day, which was equivalent to 8 to 12 8-ounce glasses of water. Tip number 5 is to have lots of skin-to-skin contact with your baby. Skin-to-skin contact helps release hormones oxytocin and prolactin, which are the two hormones responsible for milk production. So something I used to do is put my son in a diaper and leave my shirt off and just lay him right over my chest and my belly, even if we were just relaxing and not feeding, just so we can have that skin-to-skin contact. And if it was cold, I just throw a blanket and cover like the back part of his body. But it's definitely great not only for milk production, but for bonding with baby as well. The next tip might take a little longer to boost your supply, and that's what's called power pumping. So you basically set aside an hour after feeding baby and pump for 20 minutes, then rest for 10, then pump for 10, then rest for 10, then pump for 10 again. You can do this once or twice a day for about a week to increase your supply. Again, what this does is send a signal to your body that you need to produce more milk. So even if you're not pumping much, if anything, out in the beginning, the pumping serves to send the milk production signals to your body. I personally, honestly, couldn't stick with this routine. I tried a few times, but it was just too much for me. You definitely don't want to stress yourself out more during this process because that will put a damper on your supply as well. But if you do want to try power pumping, some things that can help are applying warm compresses to your breasts, actually leaning forward and letting gravity help, or doing breast compressions or massages, which can help stimulate the milk ducts and help empty your breasts. So tip number 7 is something you want to be careful about, and that is taking herbal supplements. So just a disclaimer, always consult your doctor before taking any kind of supplement. I am not a medical professional and this is not to be taken as medical advice. I'm just sharing products that help me personally, but everyone's bodies and situations are different. So I will link the products I used in the description box below so you can check them out. But some people have the opposite effect when they introduce certain herbs and it actually dries them up more. So just be careful when deciding to take supplements. One thing that did really help me was supplementing with electrolytes. I love the Ultima Replenisher and found that this really helped to keep me hydrated, and I definitely saw a boost in my supply after using this. My last tip is to relax. Being a new mom in general is so stressful, as is breastfeeding, but being relaxed helps with the letdown reflex and allows for greater milk flow. Just one last thing to remember, fed is best. If you're seriously stressing over your supply, it could be contributing to the situation. The most important thing is a healthy mama and baby. You are a warrior no matter how you feed your baby. So just keep that in mind. I hope you found these tips helpful. Please be sure to like this video and hit that subscribe button for more pregnancy and parenting tips. Also, be sure to check out theinnovativemama.com for even more content. And leave a comment below on which tip you found to be the most helpful or surprising, or if you have any other tips that you know of that I left out. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.